Nityanandam, so now we have Ma Nityananda Bodhana, who's waiting here to share her experience that she has been having. Nityanandam Ma.
Nityanandam. So yesterday I had just been describing how our Balasant, Atma Maya, how she was doing the length calculations. We were giving her those big numbers, how she was not getting any correct, but how it didn't faze her one bit. Nothing was hitting her inner space of frustration or anything, nothing that I'd seen before. That's where I left. So then what happened is, I would say after almost a half an hour of doing continuous equations without stopping, her only thing was, let's see the time go less. Let's make the time get less, so that she was going from 1 minute to 40 seconds, 30. This is what she wanted, because she said, Swamiji's doing this. All I have to do is keep doing and keep decreasing the amount of time. Then she said, let's just stop for a minute. She said, let me re-entangle, let me realign with Swamiji. So she stopped the whole process. I would say she took about 3 minutes. Just sat with herself with the eyes closed, re-looked into the Ananjana. The very next sum she got correct. And from that point, it was all correct. So this was another amazement to me at how even she caught maybe there was one small place where she wasn't aligned. Now, this went down
to 30. This is the life that we live in Gurukul.
Yeah.
Each and every moment, like, if we are not aligned, even in one thought of ours.
Ah, really?
We immediately complete it and we move ahead.
Oh my
so
God.
This science of completion is the strong thing, just again and again pulling us back to the
yes.
integrity so that we can manifest these powers continuously.
So this is what I took. I never saw this. Now I'm going to apply this to what I've seen in my life as a teacher, a parent, and the wife of a teacher. So I've seen and experienced three types of schools. My husband taught in the most prestigious school in the Dayton area, where it takes two large salaries to afford your kid to go. It's the amount of tuition you would spend on college. These kids are having the success like Atma Maya was having, but at great cost. What was really disheartening to my husband is most of these kids were on some type of antidepressant. A lot of the kids are in therapy, and there's some kids that are even suicidal because the the pressure is so intense on them to succeed at this level.
Education is supposed to bring life to us, not kill us.
No, so like I saw one side where it is an elite school. The kids are getting into the Ivy League schools. They are very successful doctors and lawyers, but at what cost? Tremendous cost. Now, about the time my husband, I don't know, he'd been there 12 years and my girls were born. My husband and I looked at what we wanted. We said we don't want our girls to be going through that kind of pressure. So then my husband switched almost opposite. He started teaching in a school with no grades and no tests. Totally opposite. The school is based on the principle that first you're handling yourself, like Swamiji says, and you're handling your environment and the kids around you. Once that's been handled, you can settle into your learning, which you own. This school is so beautiful. It was only one more step and had a Swamiji. It would be just the Gurukul. So these kids, it's called child-centered learning. So I was able to see both my girls from age 5 to age 12 go through an education with no grades and no testing and see how much flowering happened. Even though they're not experiencing, you know, depth and breadth, but it's that level. It's all heart. There is not, because the length things just came then easily. So they didn't struggle at all. Those length things came, and this is a premise of the school, that given 12 years, given how we will nurture and treat your child, they will read. They will do their maths, all of this stuff. So I witnessed this. Now we go to number 3. What happens to these kids at 12? What kind of school do they go to? First of all, I do want to tell you that then right now what's happening in the school is the attendance is going down because it's not quantifiable. The parents want a test to prove that their kids are going to make it in high school. But what I can tell you is that the local high school where they all progress to, always the valedictorian, which is the first in the class, graduating class, second is salutatorian, is always from the school, from the age 5 to 12. So that's one thing that shows that they're able to achieve the length things that are measured in school without going through testing. Oh, just a reminder.
And I just want you to share with them, like, even though in the POF, yes, what system you're telling is, of course, a different system.
Right.
But what is it kind of difference that you are finding in the Balasins here
okay.
and the kids there?
Right. So
even though that school is without any proper thing. Yes. It doesn't have any proper logic, or it doesn't it doesn't have any proper system.
Yes.
Like the so-called proper system according to Mekale.
Right.
In spite of that, still kids are going through so many things, you know.
So I want to remind you again that we're not saying, Swamiji says testing is, in the schools, is the result of violence. But you are hearing us say that these kids love to be tested. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, Balananda is saying again and again, they're saying, give me another test. So we're not just saying cross-section, no tests. The difference is the powerlessness that they go into for the testing and the powerlessness, the actual joy that these guys experience wanting more and more testing. So I want to make that clarity that we're not saying no test. Now, what's the difference? The main thing that you'll see is the hormonal ups and downs. And those hormonal ups and downs completely affect your clarity and thinking.
And it affects the whole neurological system itself. Yes. A person, if you are not having any of these hormonal ups and downs, the life that you live will be much more longer than the current life that you are having with a very weak system.
Yes.
See, you can know this very clearly with the strength that you're having in your core.
Right.
In Gurukul, because of there is no this hormonal ups and downs, we know how stable we need to be. We know what our life is for. Because of that clarity, and because Swamiji is continuously grooming us, the way he brings up each and every thought, he again and again lends us back to integrity. He raises up and he never uses anger.
Yes.
He doesn't even have that part.
Yes.
And same way, he does not allow anyone else also to get angry at us, nor have anger within us.
Right.
So we do a very beautiful process for this.
Yes. It is amazing. I wish you could all see it.
We do a very beautiful process where we actually speak to the rose plants.
Ah, yes.
And make the rose plants drop its thorns.
Oh my God.
Only see, when does a rose plant have thorns? Only for it to have protection, correct?
Right.
When will you ask for protection? Only when you think there is some person, like someone to out that to harm you.
Or violate.
Yes, something can be violating you.
Right.
Now, when you start feeling the protection within yourself, of course, you will not even ask for protection from anything outside.
Correct.
When you feel so secured, when you feel so safe in the atmosphere, in the ambience where you are growing, you will not have any need for protection.
Correct.
So that's the exact thing that we give to the rose plants.
Yes.
We speak to the rose plants, dropping all our anger. See, plants are sensitive to the space that you're having. So that's what we do. We drop all the all the anger incompletions that we are having, and we go relate to it in such a friendly way.
Right.
The way we relate it and the space from which we go, it just drops all the thorns.
Yes. And Ma, we can relate that also to the elite schools. I wanted to relate it to the elite school again with hormones, because even though those kids now are achieving, same as the other school, that level of depression, being on antidepressants, needing to be in therapy, even to the suicide level, is also hormonal. So you're seeing that extreme stress on these kids with the hormones that would be completely alleviated if they start using through the manifesting powers versus straining the, you know, the brain with a logical way of doing it.
Actually, if you see a normal average person, maximum uses 3% of the whole brain.
Yes.
Whole life, what do you believe? Whole life, they just use the 3% and die.
Isn't it terrible? It's just terrible.
It's like you're having a huge mansion to live in. So beautiful. Everything that you wished for is just filled in that.
Yes.
And many more things that you don't even know. So many things are filled in that. Yet, you lock yourself in a small room.
Yes, that's what it's
like,
yes.
And with no things in it. And you go on blaming the people for and telling that, no, I'm not having it. I'm not having this. I'm not having that. It's because, see, God is so sadistic. He's not giving me what I wanted.
Ma, it's not only that. Even before I met Swamiji, at least in the Western lifestyle, you only think there's a few options. One option is marriage. One option is good job, good profession, money, being comfortable. There is no idea that an option like this exists, where life is so expansive that you might be in an ashram, that you might be living this life, even my life. My life still with married with kids, but it's much, much expanded beyond what I ever thought. So, hey, can I tell you now what happened to me when I'm doing equations?
Yes.
Okay.
This is
So finally, Swamiji Guruji told us, the Nithyananda Yogam participants, now it's our turn to do length. So I was working with Sri Veda Priya. Now let me tell you, numbers are my big fear. It's the minute you tell me to do a number thing, I go into fear and I contract. So the first thing is that he gave me this such ridiculous equation. I didn't even know what some of it was. It had the numbers S-I-N, letters S-I-N. It had square roots. It had everything. I looked at the paper. I didn't have any fear. This was the first most amazing thing. I watched myself. Not only did I not have fear, but for me, when the Balasanta is expressing, and when I'm looking into the Krishna Sila, there's a bubbling that's in my belly that starts coming up. As soon as I looked at the paper, the bubbling started, which actually the bubbling makes me giggle. So I started giggling, and I was like, oh my God, Bodhin is giggling about doing an equation. This would never, ever have happened with me. Now I'll tell you, I didn't get a single one right, but I actually had so much fun. Who can say they can have fun sitting there doing equations, looking into Krishna Sila and consistently
And you should
getting...
tell what kind of equation also. Oh. It's all 20
oh
digit
my God.
By 20 digit.
I know what pi is, but I've never done a pi equation. I know what sine is. It's in calculus, but I've never done this equation. I'm just looking at it
and
laughing.
Actually, if you see, the kid who's giving the question itself does not know all
yeah.
these things.
Yes. Now, let me
They're
tell you one
so
thing.
They're all so small kids. They don't even know. They've see, just seen these things
yeah.
being written somewhere
yes,
in some
enjoying.
Remote notebook. And randomly, whatever number comes, he just writes everything and gives it to you.
See, now let me tell you where the joy comes from. It's because Swamiji himself is showing me what to write in the Krishna Sila. So every time I'm looking and reconnecting with again with Swamiji and laughing and having a private conversation, hey, Swamiji, what are these numbers you're giving me? This is what brings the joy, is the connection. Not any of what we call work of doing equations. So this was the little bit I want to express about length today. Okay, next I want to express about the breath dimension, because Swamiji then initiated them into breath. So breath is where there's emotion, and things like music, poetry, sculpture, art. And you can add it to length. So you could do something like, say, which artist produced this? This would be a length question. But then if you say, paint the picture that this artist painted, that becomes a breath question. So we started just having amazing fun with breath questions. So what I want to describe is a couple of very exciting things. Also in breath is GPS. Swamiji was most excited about GPS, wouldn't
that
you
was
say?
That was such a powerful
yeah,
initiation.
Yeah.
Like something that you cannot even imagine yeah. about. A GPS, a walking GPS.
Yeah.
No, actually a sitting GPS,
yeah.
which can... A human GPS, I don't
yes.
know what to call it
right.
as. Because you'll be able to sit here,
yeah.
see whatever route you want to see. And many times you'll be more accurate even than that Google map.
So the first, we gave the GPS question because Swamiji wanted. So I said to my the person I'm working with, I said, tell me where M22 is. I said it's a local route. Now she doesn't know anywhere
a
in the
local
world.
Route?
Local
that
route.
That too with numbers. Actually, normally itself you don't remember the numbers. And here the kid does not even have an idea
right.
about where you are from.
Right, right. So first thing they said is Michigan. Absolutely correct. The second thing they started drawing, Michigan has this shape. This shape is the shape of Michigan, and this is all water. So this person drew the Michigan, then she immediately drew a line up here and down and up, which was correct. This is M22. So of course we're all shocked and amazed, like they're just getting this GPS. But I wanted to move on to something more, and so the next thing I did is I asked the person to draw a Nicholas Roerich painting. Nicholas Roerich lived in the 1900s, and he was considered enlightened. He drew a lot. He stayed in the Himalayas. He painted many, many pictures. So I described what I wanted, and she started drawing mountains, and on the right-hand side, she drew a sun. Then when she got done, she goes, I'm seeing only pink, 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 pink. So we scrolled through pictures, and there's the painting. It's pink mountains, but actually,
God.
It was a vision of a figure, not the sun. I said, okay, everything's good, but this is a
figure.
So the
whole thing,
yes.
you also didn't even see the picture first
right.
before she draws it. And she draws it without even knowing what picture is. And after she describing the whole picture and she Googling it, only after she Googles it and
yes.
finds out, she even comes to know that this is the real picture.
Right. But
so,
let me tell you one more thing. The figure, she looked and she goes, oh, I saw a figure, but I thought, how can there be a figure in the sky? So I made a sun instead. So she saw the whole thing exactly.
So
it was
that
amazing.
Is the power. See, when we start manifesting all these different
mm-hmm.
shaktis,
yes.
the confidence that this gives us
the confidence
is amazing. Because see, the whole thing, whatever you may do, the main thing that need to be there in you, the purpose of your life itself, is to have a blissful life.
Yes.
And that bliss can happen only when you have a higher inner image about yourself.
Yes.
So only when we manifest different shaktis, this inner image is built in us.
Yes. Now, so the last thing I wanted to share that was so unique is that I wrote on a piece of music called Ode to Joy by Beethoven. And I asked her to look into the Christusila and see if she can hear the music. So she was very confused at first. How am I going to hear? Then I said, just start humming. So she started humming some tunes. Then she hummed six notes that are the exact beginning six notes because my ears know it. I said, stop, you got it. Now, because she doesn't know music, she doesn't know she got it. But I hummed it back and she was just like, oh my God, how did I know this? So the implications of this are amazing. Swamiji said any balasan and anyone initiated can look in the Christusila, hold an instrument and play. They can look in the Christusila, sing.
So the whole logic is broken up because anything, you know, whatever you want, you'll be able to do it.
Yes, anything. He said archery, throwing, anything you want.
Archery, just looking at a granite slab, just looking at a Christusila, you're going to do archery.
Yes, he said you can have
everything.
A mark, look in the slab. You won't look at the mark, you'll pull the string, but it will hit the mark by looking in the Yananjana. Amazing.
Thanks a lot, Ma, for sharing all these things with us.
Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for inviting me.
So, Nityanandam, now we are having Ma Shakti Rupa. You are from?
I'm from Texas. I'm from USA.
So she's waiting to share with all of us the experience that she has had regarding all these new powers and different shaktis and the shaktinipada, entanglement that she's going through. Yes.
So yes, actually I'm 22. I'm actually in the Nitya Yoga. It's a 3-month program with Swamiji, living in the presence of Swamiji himself. So just being in a space every day, being in the shaktinipada is just so amazing. And I want to share what I've been experiencing the last few days. So Swamiji, he initiated all the balasans into the depth dimension. So he was just like, there were a few balasans, Gurukul kids, and they were in the corner and, you know, they were having some coconuts. And Swamiji just said, okay, just move them. And these kids, they're just like this, they just did this with their hand. And the coconut just moved and it simply dropped. And it was like a fun game, you know. One person was it dropped.
Coconut is moving without touching.
Yes.
No one is touching it. Just with the power of the third eye and just with that Advaita with it, that feeling connection with it, the oneness with it, the coconut starts moving and levitating.
Yes, it was so shocking. It was like, you know, and then the other person starts. She, you know, the person just looks at the coconut and just smiles at the coconut and just with the hand just does a gesture like this, asking it to move up, and it simply moves up and it drops. And we're like, what is happening? And casually, it's like just in 10 seconds, 20 seconds, it just drops. And the next person starts. And simply, they were just manifesting it, about four of them. So all of us, like literally all of us, Nityananda Yogam, Gurukul kids, everyone around, everyone stood up and was just like gazing at them, you know. They were like the new attraction. And Swamiji just said, okay, now all Gurukul kids, you all start. So all of them started getting coconuts. And I was just thinking, okay, maybe these four kids, they're really in some space and maybe they will manifest. Maybe all of these kids, probably they won't manifest. So I'm just...
so much proved that you're wrong.
I was so proven wrong. So this Dhyana Maharaj, he comes with the coconut and he asks Ma Balananda, one of the participants, to hold the coconut. So he just simply looks at the coconut. And you know, see, if Swamiji told me this instruction, I will look at the coconut and I'll ask it to move up. And then if it doesn't move up in 1 or 2 minutes, I'll think I'm some loose or something. Something has gone wrong with me. And I'll just relax and, okay, this is not for me. People around me will think I'm crazy. That's what I'll be thinking. But this Balasanth, he just comes down and sits and he just so ferociously just looks at the coconut with such confidence. And he just looks at it and just looks at it. And he, you know, he does a gesture for it to move up. And he's so, that it's such a will persistence he had. Simply, I could see the coconut was just moving up, 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 up. I was like, oh my God. I could not believe it, and it just dropped.
What is the thing that you went through when you were there doing it? See, he doing it, yes, it is an amazing thing. Did you have any kind of transformation within yourself? What is the feeling that you had?
See, what I felt was when the Balasan moves the coconut. See, the coconut is in my hand. So when coconut moves, literally, because see, to move the coconut, just like how you were sharing with Ma Bodhana about the flowers and the thorns dropping, right? Just like that, I felt like to see everything literally is a shakti. It's not a siddhi, which means all these powers are expressing from oneness with and around us, right? So literally he was experiencing oneness with this coconut. So when I'm holding the coconut, he's experiencing oneness with me as well. So I'm experiencing this high intense space of Swamiji himself when he is moving the coconut. So the same love he radiates with the coconut, the same oneness he radiates with the coconut, I am feeling it. So literally when he was doing that, I felt like I was in that ecstasy. And that whole day when you're experiencing that with the coconuts, this other Balasanta was also entangling with me. His name is Mahagitananda Maharaj. And constantly he was doing this with the coconuts. And not just that, he was even making cracks in the coconuts just simply by looking at the coconut and instructing it to crack in the space of Advaita, in the space of Shaktinipada. So after this experience, after about maybe in the evening, all these Balasans left and I was in such an ecstasy. And me and my partner, we just thought, you know what, let's just try. Let's just try and see whether we can do it, right? So we are like, probably we cannot, but let's just try. So like that, casually, we just took the coconut.
And you were able to do.
Yeah. So here the story. So you know, just like the Balasans, we put the Jnananjana on our third eye and we put it on the coconut and we just did the Sadguru Vandana. And we just looked at the coconut and the moment we looked at the coconut, we felt we are Sadashiva. And simply the coconut moved and just fell. And we were like, what is happening? So it was so cool how, see, in the outer world, in anywhere else, it'll be such a, like, we'll think it's so difficult, so many complications will be associated with it, even when people tell us about it. But here, so casually, we are expressing it as though it's nothing. It's like everyone's doing it, and we're just one of the everyone, you know? So it was just so cool, like, experiencing the whole thing.
Thanks a lot, Na, for sharing. So even people out there, I mean, you guys can experience and do the things just by entangling with the Balasan, just by coming and being here. Right now, the Akashic reading is over. Every day, this Akashic reading show happens live, like around 10:30, like after immediately after satsang. So we start the Akashic reading live here. You can come here physically and get your Akashic readings read. So in the Bengaluru Adinam, then when you come here physically, you will be able to experience that same entanglement that she experienced with the Balasans. And even you will start manifesting that same joy and bliss within yourself. So, see you all soon here. And even if you want to have your Akashic readings read, you can inbox us or you can leave your contact details in the comments, or you can even inbox us. You can first register yourself in the Akashic reading link form and inbox your contact details to us. So we are waiting for and looking forward for all of you to join us and have your Akashic readings read and express the same Sadashivatva that we are expressing here. Thank you. Nityanandam.